We want to perform this division using synthetic division, and because we're dividing our polynomial by a binomial in the form of x minus k, synthetic division is an alternative to performing long division. So the first step is to list the coefficients of our dividend. So if our polynomial is given in this form, we're going to list them horizontally as a, b, c, and d. Notice how the terms are in descending order. And if any of these terms are missing, we will have to include a zero coefficient. Looking at our division problem, since we have x cubed plus 8 divided by the quantity x plus 2, we need to think of this as x cubed plus, notice how there's no x squared term, so we have 0x squared. There's also no x term, so we'll have 0x plus 8 divided by the quantity x plus 2. So when listing the coefficients, we'll have 1, 0, 0, and 8. The next step, if we're dividing by x minus k, we want k out here on the left. And notice how these are opposite signs. So if we're dividing by x plus 2, k is actually going to be negative 2. Again, the constant of our divisor is always the opposite sign of the value we're going to use here. And now to start synthetic division, we're going to start by bringing this term down. And every time we have a term down here at the bottom, we're going to multiply it by negative 2 and then move it to the next column. So 1 times negative 2 is negative 2. So we'll have a negative 2 here, and then we add vertically and repeat the process. So 0 plus negative 2 is negative 2. Then negative 2 times negative 2 is positive 4. Add vertically, so 0 plus 4 is 4. And then 4 times negative 2 is equal to negative 8. Add, and we have 0. This last term is our remainder. So we can see that x plus 2 does divide evenly into x cubed plus 8. But we can also determine the degree of our quotient by taking the degree of our dividend and subtracting the degree of our divisor. And since 3 minus 1 is equal to 2, this represents the coefficient of the degree 2 term. This represents the coefficient of the degree 1 term. This would be the coefficient of our degree 0 term, or a constant. And here's our remainder. So our quotient is equal to 1x squared minus 2x plus 4. And normally, if we have a coefficient of 1, we leave it off. So this would be our quotient. And because the remainder is 0, we know that x plus 2 is a factor of x cubed plus 8. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.